Hello, and welcome to the BNP Paribas Asset Management Talking Heads podcast. Every week, Talking Heads will bring you in-depth insights and analysis through the lens of sustainability on the topics that really matter to investors. This week, we'll be discussing developments in investment-grade credit, that's to say in corporate debt markets. I'm Andy Craig, and I'm delighted to be joined by Victoria Whitehead, who is a senior portfolio manager for investment-grade credit in our fixed income team. Welcome back, Victoria.
Thanks very much, Andrew. It's great to be back.
Listen, since the beginning of 2022, we have seen a very sharp correction in the market for investment-grade corporate bonds. And this is due to the negative impact of steeply rising government bond yields and much wider credit spreads. Is there much further to go in your view? Or have valuations now reached levels that could justify building or expanding overweight positions?
I think the short answer is there is an awful lot of bad news priced into investment grade markets at these current levels. Spreads are trading not far off where we were back in March 2020, when we were living through the COVID crisis with all the uncertainty that that brought about for the economy. We are also a long way from the tights that we saw in 2007 and in 2019. So I think we still have the possibility to trade tighter next year, given the fact that I think we will see more stability in the rates market.
Now, obviously, investors are worried about high inflation and recession risk. So far, corporate earnings have held up well in Europe. Do you think this can last? And what does it mean for company fundamentals, such as cash balances, debt levels, and earnings potential? Should we be expecting a wave of defaults and bankruptcies in 2023?
I think it's unlikely for investment grade credit, which is the companies are the highest quality. I think it's much more likely to see that default ratios will tick up in the high yield market, but we are starting from a very, very low level. I think it is inevitable that we will see earnings deteriorate from here because most of the corporates that we cover in our universe have had very good earnings year to date. The credit ratings are still very strong and we have seen a number of upgrades throughout the year, regardless of the fact that credit markets are going through a difficult phase. So I think that what we can say is that investment grade corporates are going into this crisis in a very solid position compared to previous downturns and to previous recessions.
So what do you see then as the main risks for the corporate bond market at this point?
I think that the main risk is probably going to be inflation that remains stubbornly high and that the central banks are unable to bring it down to levels far lower than what we are seeing today. If we get stubbornly high inflation, then that could mean that the economic downturn is worse than expected. And so for me, that is the biggest tail risk right now.
Okay. And how are you positioning your portfolio for 2023? Will you be maintaining an overweight in financials, that's to say in bank bonds, and in sectors that are less sensitive to the economic cycle?
Yes, we are still overweight banks, and we do still like banks as our favourite sector pick. I think that if we look how banks are currently positioned, they will benefit from the rise in interest rates, which will help their profitability. Some of this will be moderated by the fact that I think it is inevitable that we will see non-performing loans tick up. But I think that the banks have done an enormous amount of work in terms of shoring up their balance sheets since the financial crisis in 2008. The regulators have been very keen to ensure that banks have much higher capital ratios and are much better positioned to weather downturns than was previously in the case. So for me, I think that they are a better investment proposal than some of the more cyclical sectors. And furthermore, financial spreads are still very cheap compared to non-financial bonds because we have seen a lot of new supply coming into the investment grade markets issued by banks this year at very cheap levels. And we think that that has been a good opportunity to buy.
Well, Victoria, thank you very much for joining us.
Thanks very much.
That's it for this week's episode of Talking Heads. If you would like more information, please reach out to your BNP Paribas Asset Management contact. Just before we go, I'd like to mention that our 2023 investment outlook is out on Viewpoint. So you can visit viewpoint.bnpparibas-am.com to read the paper, watch the video, or listen to the podcast. If you like Talking Heads, leave us a positive review and a nice rating. We recommend subscribing to Talking Heads on your favourite podcast channel. You'll receive your podcast episodes every Monday afternoon. You've been listening to the BNP Paribas Asset Management Talking Heads podcast with me, Andy Craig, and Victoria Whitehead, Senior Portfolio Manager for Investment Grade Credit. Thank you, and talk again next week.
This presentation includes a discussion on current market events and is not intended as investment advice or an offer of products or services by BNP Paribas Asset Management. Please keep in mind that the information and analysis in this presentation is only current as of the publication date.